because you know Kanye, and you know Chance the Rapper, and you know all of these other big guys. I want them here though, you know? So we can talk about Africa with people that are making moves in America. I'm not gonna be a moderator, so I'm gonna leave it to her. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. She's gonna be your moderator for the next session. Dr. Amara Enyen. Thank you.
About this last panel of the evening. It is a pleasure to be here, coming from Chicago by way of Nigeria, Igbo. My name is Amara Enya. I'm here also with the delegation from Chicago supporting the African Union 6th region as we do the work that is necessary for the progression of our continent. There are a couple of phrases that were made today, throughout the day that you've been hearing. You've been hearing words about unity. We've been hearing that Africa is not where you were born, it's what's in the blood. That no matter where you go, we have a birthright to the continent. This panel and these panelists represent the future of our continent. It's important that as we're gathered here to talk about trade, and we'll be having conversations about the Africa Continental Free Trade Area. We'll also be talking about investment opportunities. We'll be talking about infrastructure and other practical things that are happening now. But we have to recognize that there is a paradigm shift that's happening on the continent. And the applause to our dear mother is part of that paradigm shift. It is about a different consciousness, meaning that no longer do we have the mindset of reliance on outsiders. We are actually finally relying on ourselves. That no longer do we have this mentality that we have to go outside to look for expertise and skills and gifts, but the fact of the matter is that we have everything that we need. And we have always had everything that we need. And so what has held us back? This panel is about the Africa we want. And it's called the Africa we want because it requires us to tap into the imagination of what we believe we deserve as Africans, no matter where we are in the world. Our creative imagination, our willingness to build the continent that we want, not the continent that other people think we should have, not the continent that lives at the behest and on the agenda of everyone else except ourselves, but the continent that we want and deserve. And so the questions that we have, I will take some of the ones that have been coming in through the Slido app. Hopefully all of you have gotten acquainted with it so that you can submit your questions. I do want to incorporate some of that into the conversation. And I want our panelists to talk about what the Africa we want looks like. And so I'll start with just since I want everyone to really understand some of the work that you're doing currently. So if we can just take about 30 seconds to a minute for each of you just to talk about your work and how it relates to the continent.
My name is Maxwell Amahoit. I'm the Director of Finance of the Association of African Universities. The Association of African Universities is actually the apex higher education institution for the whole continent of Africa. Established in 1967 by the African Union, UNESCO, and 34 out of the 37 universities then existing in Africa. Currently, we have over 400 universities as members. But virtually every higher education institution in Africa is a stakeholder of the association, referred to as the AAU. The Association of African Universities is actually the coordinating body or the lead implementing agency for the African Union on issues of higher education. And back home in Accra, we host the Secretariat for the African Union for the continental or decadal continental education strategy. most of the initiatives on the continent relating to African higher education is actually more or less promoted and advocated for by the Association of African Universities. So virtually, when we're talking about higher education on the continent of Africa, the impact body that we look at first is the Association of African Universities before we consider any other sub-regional bodies. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is John Kilama. I was born in the northern part of Uganda. I left Uganda because we had a leader who was interested in killing people. And his name was Idi Amin. I settled in Kentucky, where I got my undergraduate degree, and then went on to pharmacy school at the University of Kentucky. And I also live in Texas. I also live in Arizona. I also live in Minnesota. I also live in Delaware. But at the same time, I also visited over 41 countries in Africa. I trained over 1,000 Africans on the issues of intellectual property. How many of you know what intellectual property is? Because there were ideas developed by Africans that were being moved out of the continent without any compensations. And that's the most proudest thing I've done in my life. From West Africa to East Africa, the only place I never went to was North Africa. I had intended, but 2/11 destroyed it. So I look forward to having some interesting discussions regarding what Africa really needs to be, because I've seen it from Nairobi to Accra, from Cairo to Abidjan. I've seen it in person.
Before we go into the next introduction, I wanted to invite Mr. Gabriel Shumba also up to the panel. He is the CEO of Group Shumba, which is an investment company doing business both here and on the continent. I wanted to make sure I invite him.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Nasibu Sorema, born and raised in Tanzania. Any Tanzanian in the room? That is so sad. I know there's a lot of Tanzanian in Texas. Where are the Tanzanians? All right. So this is so sad in Dar es Salaam for sure. So I don't have 30 seconds. Before I tell you a little bit about what I do in Minnesota, I live in Minnesota, exactly the same question that I just asked right now. We did a trade mission with then Congressman Keith Ellison of East Africa. We went to Tanzania, visited Tanzania Investment Center. We're seated there and then we're looking into it actually is doing a whole lot of investment in Tanzania. Then we started going through the list. I was seated right next to Congressman Keith Ellison then, who is our Attorney General in Minnesota. And when we were going through the list, I was so surprised actually to see who are actually investing in Tanzania. Now, what I really wanted to know whether the United States actually does any investment, or how much of investment the US does, not only in Africa, but in Tanzania. Guess what? They were not on the top 10. So the first three countries, which I was so surprised, they were all European countries, but I was so amazed when to come and realize that out of the top three, one of them was actually an African, an East African country that was actually investing hugely in Tanzania. And I know a lot of Kenyans don't know that. I was so surprised. Now, I run a community development financial institution in Minnesota. Started about 15 years ago. The pundits told us, why would you want to start another organization that does financial institutions, does small business lending? There are a bunch of small business lenders already doing what you're doing. And our push back was very simple, that we want to run an organization that is culturally competent. You see, we want to empower, economically, financially empower our community in the state of Minnesota so that actually they'll be able to do a lot of work in the continent. I'm so honored to be seated right next to Mama. Call her my Mama. When I first hear her speaking, I right away went and approached her and I said, can I please invite you to Minnesota? Right away I said, there is something that you have that I know I want to work on. And I was the very first one to invite her to Minnesota. I know she has been there several times. And ever since, I've been all over the continent working with her. Now, lastly, I'm building up a platform in Minnesota. Our work is a coordination of public-private partnership. We are the largest small business lenders to African immigrants in the country. We started doing our lending up to $300,000 per one business last year. My intention is to build a platform. It's not about what we do right now. My intention is to actually build a platform that is gonna be able to do a whole lot of work. Because if, at this point in time, I want us to be about $20 million organization, very small, we could easily be 100 million. But if we have that, that means we're gonna be financially self-sustained organization. Guess what? We're gonna be able to do anything that we want to do. We already have the leverage right now, but I would like for us to be able to create a platform that actually is gonna allow us to do a whole lot of things in the continent.
Thank
I will
you.
Stop there and then I will share the rest that I've done with the ambassador.
Good evening, my fellow African diaspora and friends of Africa.
Good evening.
Woo!
I'm Arkana Chiobori. I'm just a black woman who's sick and tired of being sick and tired. To put it very simply, and I'm just one who believes that the origins of humanity, the inheritors of one of the most amazing continents on earth, can no longer continue to be the most disrespected people on earth. And that whatever it takes for us to come together, you see, those who took our independence from us, even the political that we're supposed to have, we still don't have that. And the economic liberation that we were never given and we were denied, we don't expect them to just give it to us. We just have to take it. And the time to take it is now. I don't know about you, but I'm a grandmother, a mother of five, and a grandmother of five. I look at my grandkids, and I know one thing is clear, that I do not wish to live this world the way it is for black people, for them. And I'm also very clear, crystal clear, that if we, this generation, if we do not fix it for them, we are leaving them to servitude for thousands of more years. I don't think that's what you guys want. I know for a fact that's not what I want. And I can speak on behalf of millions of grandmothers out there. I do know what I want for my grandkids. They too want it for their grandkids. So as we gather today and tomorrow, my hope is we chart the way forward, that we join the ranks of other races that have come together and said enough is enough, and look back and did what needed to be done for their countries of origin. Let's take a page out of the Chinese. 30 years ago, China was a developing country. Let's join hands, just like the Chinese diaspora did. I know. We are the most intelligent, most hardworking people I know. Once we let go of the shackles of the mind, which is where the real disease is, the disease that's not only having us in the doctor's office, not in the hospital, but within the hospital, we're actually in the intensive care. The question is, do we even realize that we are so sick that we're in the intensive care? So I hope that as we go through today and tomorrow, ask yourself, am I colonized? Am I suffering from the legacy of slavery? Do I have the shackles of the mind? And do I admit that I am a sick black person and that I need healing? And the healing that I desire begins with me. And only when I heal thyself and I accept that I am sick, but not only sick, but very sick, then and only then can true healing begin. And that's with you. At the end of tomorrow, we shall have a movement, which we shall decide on a name. At the end of tomorrow, we shall have a database that all black people around the globe are going to belong to in preparation for the launching of the African Continental Free Trade Area July next year. At the end of the day, tomorrow, we're also going to have the parameters for what we are calling the Diaspora Fund. We're going to pull all our monies together and truly be the financial firewall that Africa needs. For no more shall we continue to depend on aid. No more. No more shall we look to the master for our needs. And remember, we're programmed to think that way. And a young man came to me with a nice program, business plan. And when he was done with the business plan, he said, Ambassador, all I need is $10 million. As long as you're looking to someone else to fund your project, you are still a slave. Yes. The reality is, we have what it takes to take care of ourselves. Yes. 1 million people with $1,000, that's $1 billion. Can we not do that?
Yes.
Now let's make it 2 million.
Yes.
There are 50 million of us in the United States alone. Close to 400 million of us around the globe. Give me 5 million with $1,000. Can we not do that?
Oh, yeah.
How bad do things have to be before we can say enough is enough? That I am going to trust my brother. That I am going to trust my sister. So my hope is, by the end of tomorrow, those of you who are here can leave this beautiful city of Dallas completely awoken and ready to build the Africa that we want.